मेरे स्टूडेंट, मैं आज आपको इस वीडियो लेक्चर पे एयर वेसल का सिग्निफिकेंस बताऊंगा और सिंगल एक्टिंग के केस में और डबल एक्टिंग के केस में एयर वेसल लगाने से कितना परसेंट वर्क सेव होता है उसके बारे में बताऊंगा। ठीक, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द लेक्चर आई विल डिफाइन एयर वेसल। एक्चुअली द एयर वेसल इज अ चैम्बर इन विच बॉटम पोर्शन हैविंग fluid and upper portion having the air. When the air vessel is fitted in any reciprocating pump, then head loss due to friction occurs in suction and delivery pipe, and when the air vessel is used, this work which is to be performed against the friction, that would be controlled up to the some percentage. So there are some following cases: case 1, case 2. Case 1 is that when the air vessel is not used. Case 2 is that when the air vessel is used. तो क्या होता है जब केस वन हम यूज़ करते हैं, केस वन जब एयर वेसल यूज नहीं करते हैं तो क्या होता है? क्योंकि हम हेड ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शनल लॉसेस को ही क्या कर रहे हैं, यहाँ पे कंट्रोल कर रहे हैं, तो ये पैराबोला जो मिल रहा है ये एक्चुअल सेगमेंट है, अब कोई एयर वेसल नहीं लिख रहा है। ठीक है, तो फिर क्या है, यहाँ पे यू कैन सी ड्यूरिंग द सक्शन स्ट्रोक एंड ड्यूरिंग द डिलीवरी स्ट्रोक, देन व्हाट हैपेंस ड्यूरिंग सक्शन स्ट्रोक, इट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम थीटा इज इक्वल टू जीरो एंड इट गोज इन द मिडल, थीटा इज इक्वल टू 90 एंड दिस स्ट्रोक थीटा इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री इज नोन एज मिडल ऑफ स्ट्रोक, एंड एट थीटा इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री इट रीचेज एट द एंड ऑफ द स्ट्रोक। तो फ्रॉम दिस वे, फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग स्ट्रोक टू एंड ऑफ स्ट्रोक, स्ट्रोक इज कम्प्लीटेड ड्यूरिंग द सक्शन, and this whole stroke is known as suction stroke, and the maximum length traveled by the piston inside the cylinder is known as stroke length. It means this length having a dimension of stroke length, and stroke length is equal to 2 times of crank radius. Now this represents a atmospheric line. Below the atmospheric line this denotes HS, and frictional segment, this head denotes head due to frictional losses, and it is denoted by HFS. And above the atmospheric line, this denotes delivery pressure head, and this denotes, or the segment of parabola, it denotes the frictional losses delivery pipe will be represented by the HFD. The same stroke theta is equal to 90, theta is equal to 0, theta is equal to 180 degree is seen at the delivery stroke. Okay, now what happens when we use air vessel? When we use air vessel, what happens? This parabola segment converted into the rectangle segment. That's why the area of indicator diagram increases. The area of indicator diagram is larger than that indicator diagram area when the air vessel were not used, because when the air vessel is used and we get greater area indicator diagram, that's why we get larger value of indicator diagram and we get more value of work done per second. Okay, now for that case when the air vessel is not used, and let us be assumed that for a single acting reciprocating pump, the air vessel, actually we have already discussed, for the velocity of fluid inside the pipe will be represented by small v is equal to capital A by small a omega r sin theta, where capital A is equal to cylinder area, small a is equal to pipe area, omega is speed of that reciprocating pump, small r crank radius, theta is stroke angle. Okay, now when the air vessel is used, we know that uniform velocity takes place inside the pipe as well as cylinder, and that uniform velocity is known as mean velocity. And the for the mean velocity formula will be taken such as V bar is equal to capital A by small a omega r by pi. Okay. Now, further, because air vessel basically use होता है तो कुछ ना कुछ जो friction के against work होता है, which type of work is to be performed against the friction, that is to be controlled by using air vessel. And what happens? Head loss due to friction, HF, is equal to 4FLV square upon 2VG. Okay. And we have already discussed for the velocity inside the pipe when the air vessel is not used, that is capital A by small a omega r sin theta. Then we put this value of velocity in this expression of frictional head losses, and we get this expression HF is equal to 4FL and 2DG into capital A by small a omega r sin theta by whole square. Now, this implies that the work done by the pump pile stroke against the friction, it would be represented by W1, okay, because the air vessel resumes some work against the friction. So we will have to calculate the area of frictional segment, and we know that when the air vessel is not used, then the parabola took place, and so we are trying to find the value of area of parabola. We know that area of parabola is equal to 2 by 3 into base into height. Here the base is stroke length and height is total head due to frictional losses. Now we get the value of W1 is equal to 2 by 3 into capital L into 4FL and 2DG into capital A by small a omega r ka whole square. Okay, where capital L is equal to stroke length, where small l is the length of the pipe and small d is the diameter of the pipe, and small g is the acceleration due to gravity, and 4F is the friction factor. Now we have the value of W1. Now we will find the value of W2 when the air vessel is used.